Here we're asked to prove that the limit as x approaches 3 of 2x minus 1 equals 5. Now the first thing I want to do is make sure that's right. So if I do direct substitution, x equals 3, I'll have 2 times 3, which is 6, minus 1 is 5. Okay, so to prove this, we're going to use an epsilon delta argument. Okay, so the limit as x approaches a of f of x equals L means that given any epsilon greater than 0, there is a delta such that if x minus a is less than delta, then f of x minus L is going to be less than epsilon. Okay, so in our particular case, if x minus a, in our case, we have x minus 3. If x minus 3 is going to be less than delta, then what we're going to have to prove is that f of x minus L is less than epsilon. So let's explore what this quantity is. Right, so f of x is 2x minus 1, so minus L, L is 5, that's the limit. And when I do the math here, I'll get 2x minus 6. That 2 can factor out of the absolute value, leaving me with 2 times absolute value of x minus 3. But remember, the absolute value of x minus 3 is less than delta, so this is less than 2 times delta, which has to be equal to epsilon. That tells me that delta is going to be half of the epsilon that's given. All right, so that's the hard part. We need to figure out what the delta is given the epsilon for this particular problem. And so if somebody says epsilon is, say, 0.01, then the delta is going to be 0.01 divided by 2, right? Half of that. Okay, so that's our definition, and we found the proper delta for this particular problem. Now, what's left is for us to write up the proof. All right, so we want to write it up nice. So here's the proof. Given any epsilon greater than 0, we're going to choose delta to be equal to epsilon over 2, because we already did the discovery part. So that if x minus a, so x minus 3, is less than epsilon over 2, then f of x minus L, we have to prove that this is less than epsilon. Okay, so it's basically the same calculation that we did over there. Right, so f of x, which is 2x minus 1, minus the L, comes out to 2x minus 6. Factoring out the 2, we get x minus 3. Okay, notice these are all straight equals so far. So now, at this point, I know absolute value of x minus 3 is less than epsilon over 2. Okay, and then the 2's cancel, and we get out epsilon. And that's what we were trying to prove. We were trying to prove f of x minus L is less than epsilon. Okay, and that's the epsilon delta proof for this particular problem, which happens to be a linear function.